smell of no big cookies. My fire stick is up and running. I can't believe I didn't pack any pants. It's freezing here. Thankfully, Kirsten's fit me and I can breathe just fine. And this robe, I acted like it was because it was cold, but it's pretty aesthetically pleasing. Whew.
No. No big cookies? No.
What is that?
What? No, not the fire stick. Where is the fire stick?
Here, people, this is what happened. Here's the facts. The power went out at 7:05 p.m. And within that time, my fire stick that I brought for me and you guys disappeared. The no-bake cookies that I was going to bring my no-sugar rule and eat them are gone. Those two things... It's just that, but it is a travesty, and I'm going to interview each one of you, not interview, interrogate, and unless you have an alibi of why it's not you, then you are guilty.
I'll see you in court.
Hair slip back enough?
Emily, one of the people I most suspect. I think the man is... He's asleep. You were just doing your makeup. How do you even function in life? Next!
Here for a formality. I know you didn't do it. You're always so innocent. Righteous anger, am I right?
I don't know how it could have been me, because I was asleep by 6:30. So.
I wake up at 5 a.m. every day. Justin, what are we even doing here? Do you have kids?
Yes, Shelby, I do have kids, obviously, and they are safe with Molly, so... Make sure you guys don't do anything dangerous, okay? Carter, are you okay? Look, ow, I'm hurt too. Now you don't have to tell your parents. Right?
What are you wearing?
Whatever I want to wear, Shelby. Are you saying you don't like it? A perfect alibi for you, Mallory. You're sitting there watching your phone, so no one could blame you. You got your headphones in, pretending not to listen. But I know you better than they do. You are the one who probably got annoyed at something one of us did. You have no alibi, you have no leg to stand on, and I know it was you, so you have to answer for yourself!
What?
I hope no one asked me to do anything, because I won't. Like, where was I? Like, I was working out. Like, oh my gosh, I work out all the time. Whey? Have you tried whey? I do it every day. Not too much, though. And I only use water. Those people who use milk and stuff like that, they're not even really working out. This is water right now. I drink water all the time. I'm so hydrated. Theatrics. Anyways, can we not talk about Taylor Swift for just one second?
Stop you right there. This is Taylor you're feeling right now.
Seriously. I'm not feeling any Taylor.
Oh my gosh, my whole body hurts.
Where was I? I was like, oh my god. I can't do that without leg pain. Ooh! Do you have a cup? Can someone give me my Yeti? Oh my god. Ooh. That is so hard. Is that sugar free? You guys are gross. Is that even organic? Oh my gosh. And speaking of oh my gosh, like Avery's wedding, let's just bring that up. All the Taylor Swift songs in the world. I think. Okay, so like my alibi was like, oh, okay. How can I be a background dancer for Taylor Swift? Okay. You should have said no!
Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods yet? Are we out of the woods?
This man brought his new girlfriend. I'm like, oh my gosh, baby, I'm just gonna shit to your friends. Talk to my friends, talk to me. But we are never, ever, ever. Shai is really tired, so she. I'm gonna have to explain myself to you people. Shai's getting real tired, so we gotta skedaddle.
Where was I at? I was at chapter 5. You want me to tell you about it?
Absolutely not.
Okay, well, I'm gonna tell you anyway. So, there's a part in this book, she says, it only took a few days for my ankle to feel good enough that I could walk on it again. Normal people that don't read as much as me think that's just like a regular sentence, you know, like about her ankle, but no, there's a deeper meaning. So the ankle represents... I like you the most, you the second most, you're okay, but you...
You can go. Ooh, what is this? Oh, you got a table. Oh, and anyway, wait. What is this? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know why this is here. I don't know what you think you're doing. I don't even eat Häagen-Dazs. Oh. That's the good stuff. That makes me seem guilty if I eat this. I've been on a diet.
Carter, you're done with these, right? Okay, and Delilah, you're full? You...
Where I was at? I was at that, I was at that one place.
Sue, look at my hat. Justin just left it, so I tried it on. I think it looks like a bad man with jam.
Ladies, get you a man that will come to your rescue when you run out of gas. My hubby Lee filled my gas tank up after I texted him that I ran out of gas. He is such a good husband.
Never check the gas.
Get you a man like mine. And all of these comments are like,
Susie, fill up your gas is probably what it said.
Yeah. We need to call the girls in here.
So you're saying we need to do a
Yeah.
Family meeting!
Damn blasted, where is Cheryl? Of course she's not here, of course.
Sorry I'm late, I was talking to our neighbors across the street. Did you know they live 32.2 miles away from Owensboro? Also, they have a son your age as a kid, the same age as Carter. So, where do we get started?
Well, what? Could you? Why? Hurry up, please! You're ruining my moment, Mom!
They just keep it so cold in here all the time. Almost there.
That was the truth. That was the truth. You were just so cold. Oh, I'm Cheryl and I'm always freezing. Oh, Cheryl. Oh, well, I'm burning up. I'm burning up, so I'll show you cold.
I have to find a snack. I'm getting too frustrated. I can't believe the Nova cookies are still gone. Even if I catch this criminal, they're gone.
Mamma mia, I know who did.
Hey Justin, I'm a youth pastor. Okay, let me just tell you where I'm at. Where was I doing at that time? I was on a hike. A hike, yes. That's right, you were on a hike, but you're forgetting some of the story, Don. I had to think long and hard about it, but who loves no-bake cookies more than anything? That would be you, Papa Bear. And out of everyone here, who has the means to shut off the power at a vacation home? You. And the light that I saw
It seemed a lot like a headlamp, and I know none of us brought a headlamp here. But we've always got something prepared, just in case. Dumb. Oh, you thought I wouldn't get it. You fool! You fool! The part that gets me is that you took my fire stick. But it didn't make sense. Why would you take the fire stick? And then I remember, every time that I would go to your guys' house, there was always one thing, a constant, that would be playing on your TV at any point given that I was there. Judge Judy. And I'm going to present you with a question. How do you think Judge Judy would feel about you right now? Because I'm thinking not so good. Isn't it ironic that the show that you love most, that you wanted to watch, you could be one of the I don't want to say it, the criminals, sitting there being judged by Judy. You're a disappointment to me right now. I called the cops. I don't know if they're going to get here, because they didn't seem like this was an actual issue, but if they do show up, hopefully I can turn on the TV on my fire stick from the comfort of my home, and I can watch getting pulled away into the courtroom and being judged by Judge Judy. And now I can't even look at you. I can't call you Donald. There's only one name for you. You're the Gatlinburglar.
Hello, family. I smell no baked cookies. They know I have a peanut allergy.
Stay home on Thanksgiving. Cook a turkey.
Justice.